from AIIMS, Dr. Gulatia, please.
Namaskar. This is an unfortunate incident jo aaj subah hua Vishakhapatnam mein, gas leak jo hai. This is, as has been already told, it's a compound styrene, which is an alkaline benzene compound. Agar hum is compound ki baat karein, to it can basically cause harm to humans by inhalation, by ingestion, by effect on the skin and effect on the eyes, what we call ocular effect. Inhalation say it can cause mucosal irritation, irritation in the throat, in the airways, which can lead to coughing. It can lead to breathing difficulty and wheezing or whistling sound in the chest. And if the inhalation is at a higher level, it can lead to breathlessness and respiratory distress. The absorption of this compound can also lead to what we call CNS depression. That is, affects the brain, leading to headache, nausea, vomiting, weakness, fatigue, unsteadiness of gait. People get unsteady and have difficulty in walking and sometimes fall because of that. In high exposure, it can lead to coma, pulmonary edema, and sometimes even lead to irregular heartbeat. Effect on the skin is usually mild in the form of irritation, itching, some degree of dermatitis can happen, and it can also irritate the eyes, leading to again irritation. A syndrome known as styrene sickness has also been described, which leads to nausea, vomiting, and again unsteady gait, which has been said could be in a drunken state. There is, as far as treatment is concerned, there is no specific antidote. There is no definite medicine for reversing the effect of this compound, and treatment does remain mainly supportive. The first thing that one needs to do is remove the individuals from the affected area, and as you've heard, that has been done aggressively since early morning. Individuals, because of exposure that can happen through clothes are to be removed. The exposed eyes can be washed with water, and you can use an absorbent like tissue or towel to clean the skin so that the deposition of the skin is clean. Water can also be used. And then these individuals have to be monitored for any breathing difficulty and for any drowsiness, because like I said, it can affect the lungs but can also affect the brain. Main treatment strategy is to watch out for any breathing difficulty and airway management. Some of these patients will require to be intubated and put on a ventilator. Many will just require oxygen therapy, and we have to monitor for their oxygen, respiratory rate and their CNS depression. If there is bronchospasm or breathing difficulty, sometimes nebulization can also be given as far as treatment is concerned. In some, there is some data that in very sick patients, even steroids have been given when there is acute lung injury. So by and large, it tends to be an illness which is not universally fatal. In most people, there is good recovery. It causes more irritation of the airways, and depending on the degree of exposure, the effect can be much higher. So those who have had a very close exposure, they are the ones who have a higher chance of having severe effects. Currently, as has been said, that although a large number of people are admitted in the hospital, most of them are stable and should hopefully make a good recovery. Thank you.